Lo va a negar para hecho.
Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Morning. How many of you have attending? So I can see there are 8 participants. There are 8 participants, 9. Okay, let others.
I think, sir, many of them are. Yes, they are coming.
Many of them.
Sir, few of them are still coming, sir. We can, it will be better if we will wait for 5 minutes, sir.
Okay. I will be waiting for 5 minutes. Let them come.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
So have you seen the notice?
Regarding what, sir?
Regarding your exam and all that.
No, sir. Sir, actually, we did not get any notice. The notice was for only for the final years.
Oh, so there was a notification for final years only.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I am planning to.
Sir, what about us?
Yes.
Sir, what about our exams, sir?
Still I don't know, but if there will be an exam, then exam will be held after June, I think.
Okay. After June, okay, sir.
So in the month of June, first final year exam will be held. I mean, some sort of assignments and Viva Vasi exam will be held for final year only. So once final year exam is over, then rest of the semesters exam will be held. And when I will be talking, you should all mute your microphone, okay?
Okay, sir.
And if anyone wants to talk, then he or she can unmute his microphone. Okay. Should I start now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today we will cover HipShot algorithm. So HipShot algorithm is another. Yes. HipShot algorithm is another sorting algorithm which has been used in. Many applications in computer science. For example, heap data structure itself used in many applications in order statistics related problem. So today we will cover this HipShot algorithm. So before we start HipShot algorithm, let us find some useful information about HipShot algorithm. So HipShot algorithm is a comparison based sorting technique based on binary heap data structure. Okay, so it is similar to selection sort algorithm. So if you can remember selection sort algorithm, where we find the minimum element from the array and it is then exchanged with the first element of the array. So this is continued for rest of the elements. So similarly, in the heap sort, we find the maximum element or maximum item, and we place this maximum element at the end of the array. Okay, and we repeat this same process for remaining elements also. Now, what is the second information? The second information about HipShot is it is basically insert all objects into a heap, okay, and then we pops up elements one by one, storing them into an array. And third useful information about HipShot is it is in place algorithm. Why it is called in place algorithm? Because it does not need an auxiliary storage. Okay, so here we use the constant amount of storage, same as that of the number of elements found in the array. So therefore, it is called in-place sorting algorithm. Now we will define the binary heap. What we call binary heap? So before we define binary heap, let us look at the definition of complete binary tree. So a complete binary tree is a binary tree in which every level except possibly the last is completely filled and all nodes are as far as left as possible. So what does this mean? So in a complete binary tree, we see all the levels are filled except possibly the last one. So last level will be filled from left to right fashion. That means, so all the nodes will be found as far as left in the last level. And a binary heap is a complete binary tree where items are stored in a special order. So what does this mean, special order? So special order means the value in a parent node is greater or smaller than the values in its two children nodes. The former is called as max heap and the latter is called min heap. The heap can be represented by binary tree or array. Okay. So let us consider an array where unsorted elements will be given. Okay. Now from this unsorted array, what we do? We will build a binary tree. Then we will apply heapify operation. So this heapify operation will be applied to a particular node. That means it starts with a particular node and subsequently it is used for the remaining elements. And after that we build a binary heap. And once we have the binary heap, then we find the maximum element at the root. Okay, maximum element at the root. That means the maximum value will be found at the root, and then we exchange this maximum element with the last element, with the last element of the binary heap. Okay, then we remove the last element which is having the maximum element, and it is been inserted at the last position of the array. Okay, so let me know if you have any question from this part.
So what did you say about the last statement? After exchanging the maximum element,
first there will be an array. Okay, so array will be given, unsorted array. So from that unsorted array we will build a binary tree, and in that binary tree elements will not be in any order. That means no order will be followed in that binary tree. And from that binary tree we will build a binary heap. Okay, and from that binary tree, when the binary heap will be built, in that binary heap we will have the maximum element at the root node. Okay, so root node will be having the maximum element. Then this maximum element will be exchanged with the last element of the, that means the last element will be found in the last node. That means the last level of the last level. Okay, and then this maximum element will be exchanged with the last element, and then we remove the maximum element from the last node and insert into the insert an empty array. That means that the last position, that maximum element will be inserted. Now here to represent a binary heap we use array. So why array based representation is useful for binary heap? Because it is easy to represent the binary heap using array, and it is quite regular practice that we use array for binary heap. Since binary heap is a complete binary tree, so it can be easily represented as array, and array based representation is space efficient. So this is the main reason why we use array based representation for binary heap. So here we consider the array which needs to be sorted. Okay, so we consider the following rules. What are the rules? The first rule says that element at index 0 is the root. Okay, that means the parent node, if we consider the parent node is having index I, okay, then the left child will be found at 2 into i plus 1, and right child will be found 2i plus 2. Okay, so why this formulation is necessary? Because when we apply the heapify operation to build up a binary heap, we have to apply this heapify operation at any node. Okay, that means not just any node, the node of these children must be heapified. That means it is a bottom-up approach. So we follow the bottom-up approach and we apply the heapify operation at the node, at the parent node, for which the children nodes are already heapified. Okay. So if we consider the heapify operation is applied at index I, then the left child will be found at 2i plus 1 index and right child will be found at 2i plus 2 index. Okay. And parent of the child will be I minus 1 divided by 2. Now let us look at the heap sort algorithm for sorting in increasing order. So first we build a max heap from the input data. Suppose here we have an array, and this array contains 7 elements, okay, 12, 35, 87, 26, 9, 28, and 7. Now this unsorted array will be given to you. Now from this unsorted array, you will build a binary tree. Okay, so on the left hand side, we can see a binary tree where the first element 12 is inserted as root node. Okay, then remaining elements will be inserted into the binary tree from left to right. That means first we insert 12, then we insert 35 as the left child of the 12. Okay, then we insert 87 as right child of 12. And then we have 26, and 26 will be inserted as left child of 35. Then we have 9, and 9 will be inserted as right child of 35. Then we have 28, 28 will be inserted as left child of 87, and remaining element 7 will be inserted as right child of 87. Now this binary tree is built up. When we have this binary tree, now from this binary tree, we will build up a binary heap. Okay, binary heap by applying heapify operation. Now to obtain the binary heap, in the binary heap we will see the maximum element will be found at the root node. Okay, and the binary heap will be look like this. On the right hand side we have another binary tree which is called binary heap. And in the binary heap, here we can see that 87 is found. 87 here is the maximum value. So therefore, 87 will be found at the root. Okay. Now we will see the heapify operation, how heapify operation works to build up this binary heap. Now we will apply heapify operation at index I. Okay. Now, where we first apply this heapify operation, that means at which node we will apply this heapify operation. Now let us consider an array which contains 6 elements, 1, 12, 9, 5, 6 and 10. Okay, so here n equals to 10, that is n represent the number of elements in the array. Okay, and here I represent the index for any node. Okay, where the heapify operation will be applied. Now how to find I? That means how to find the node where the first heapify operation will be applied. Now to find the I, we will consider the number of elements which are found in the array. So here number of elements is 6. So therefore 6 will be divided by 2 and then we will subtract 1. So here I is found to be 2. Okay, so if we consider here on the binary tree on the left hand side, here we can see the index for root node is 0. Okay, and then remaining elements are inserted from left to right fashion. That means here 35, index of the left child of 12 is 1, then 87 is 2, 26 is 3, 9 is 4, 28 is 5, 7 is 6. Okay. So index for root node is 0. So we will start from, so when the indexing will be done, so indexing will start from a root node. So now here we have to apply the EPPI operation. So for the first EPPI operation, we have to find out the index I for a node. Okay. So here I is found to be 2. That means we will start from index 2. So here we can see index 2. So that means first we use this element, 6 elements, to build up a binary tree. Now binary tree has been built. Now we will find the index 2. So index 2 represent the node 9. Okay. So we will apply EPPI operation, first EPPI operation at node 9. That means if we create a EPPI function where 3 parameters are used, one is array and number of elements 6 and the node at index 2. Okay, so array comma 6 comma 2. So that means we will apply the EPPI operation at node 2. So here we can see that the node 2 at index 2, we are having 9, and 9 is less than the left child 10. Okay, so therefore we go for exchange. So 10 will be exchanged with 9, and after exchange with 9, we will have the second So can you all hear me, or it was disrupted?
Hello. Yes, sir. So PPT is gone.
What is going on?
PPT is gone.
No, it
Hello,
was.
Ben.
Let me start. So have you listened to when I started EPPI operation?
Yes, sir.
So
sir,
yes, tell me,
sir, will you just once show that slide, array based representation of heap sort? Sir, the second slide, I think. Second or third slide. Sir, I didn't follow that.
This one?
No, the previous one.
This one?
This one.
Okay, so which part you don't understand?
No, I didn't follow that actually, sir.
Okay.
I am just going.
Okay. Okay, let me explain it again. So for binary heap, we use array-based representation. Now array-based representation is easy to have a binary heap, and it has also another advantage that array-based representation is space efficient. Okay, so now when we have a binary heap, before we have a binary heap, we apply the following rules. So what are those rules? The first rule says that element at index 0 is the root. Okay. Now for any node of the heap at index I, that means we have to find this index I for a particular node where we will apply a EPPI operation to build up a binary heap. Okay. Now if we consider this index is I, then we will find the left child of this of the corresponding parent node at 2i+1. Okay, so index for that left child will be 2i+1, and index for right child will be 2i+2. Okay, now since we have to apply the heapify operation at any node at index I, therefore to find the I, we will take help this equation, that is i-1/2. Okay, so parent of the node will be i-1/2.
Okay,
sir. Is it okay for you?
Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Any other questions?
No, sir. Continue.
Okay. So, could I start from this heapify operation? From this slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So yeah, this was completed. No, it's a continuous.
It was completed.
No, sir. Sir. Sir, the parent of the node is the index number.
I am not able to listen you.
So what is the parent of the node meaning?
Parent of the node. I mean, it is applicable for a subtree. It is applicable for the whole tree. Okay, and so if we consider, so let us consider this heapify, first of heapify operation. So to apply the first heapify operation, we have to find out the I index for a particular node. So what will be the value of I? That is to be figured out. Okay, so here since array is having 6 elements, so n will be n equal to 6. That means n represent the number of elements in the array. Okay, and I represent the node at which the first heapify operation will be applied. To find out I, we will follow this formula, that is 6/2-1. Okay, so we can start from this ith node, and ith node will ith index will represent some node in the binary tree. Okay, so here 6/2-1, so I equals to 2. So since I is found to be 2, therefore the index for the node at which the heapify operation will be applied is 2. Okay, so here first we build up a binary tree from the given array. Okay, then here we can see that index 2 represent the node 9. Okay, and since the value of this node is found to be less than the value of the left child, so if we consider 9 as the parent node, okay, and 10 is the left child, so right child is empty. So now since 9 is less than 10 and 10 is greater than 9, therefore 9 will be exchanged with 10. So now 10 comes to the parent position and 9 comes to the child position. That means 9 will be exchanged with 10, and 9 will be designated as the left child of 10. Okay, so up to this I think you have understood.
Yes sir.
Is it okay for you?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next we go to the next slide. Now, since we started from I equals to 2, now I will be decremented by 1. And when the I will be decremented by 1, I will be found to be 1. Okay. Now the value of I will be 1. That means 1 means now the second heapify operation will be applied at the node which is identified by index 1. Okay, index 1. So index 1 represent the node 12. Okay, so now 12 is found to be greater than 5 and 6. So it is already in a particular order. So order in which we have to find out the maximum, we have to find out the value at the parent which is to be, which is greater than, which must be greater than from left child and right child. Okay, so here we can see that 12 is greater than from 5 and 6. Okay, so therefore we don't need to exchange 12 with 5 or 6. It is already in order. Okay, now I will be decremented by 1 and I will be found to be 0. Now the value of I is 0. 0 means we will look at the root node. That means now if we see the value of the root node, the value of the root node is 1. Okay, so 1 is less than 12 as well as 1 is less than 10. Again, 12 is greater than 1 and 12 is greater than 10. Okay, now 1 will be exchanged with 12, and when 1 will be exchanged with 12, 12 will go to the root position and 1 will come to the left child position. So after exchanging 1 with 12, we will see the lower left, in the lower left position we can see the binary tree where we see the root node is having 12 value and the left child is having 1. Now since here we can see that the left child of 1 is build up a another subtree rooted at 1, and 1 is greater than 1 is here, 1 is found to be greater than 5, 1 is found to be less than 5 and as well as less than 6. Okay, now 1 will be exchanged with 6 because we have to find the value at the parent which is greater than from the left child and right child. So 1 will be exchanged with 6. So after exchanging with 6, we will have the binary heap on the right hand side. So we can see the right hand side, the final binary heap, where we can see that 12, the maximum value is found at the root node. Okay. And the corresponding arrow will be 12, 6, 10, 5, 1, 9. Okay, let me know if you have any questions,
sir,
from this part.
सर जो पहला वाला एग्जांपल है ना जिसमें वो एरे बना था,
कौन सा बोलो,
12 35 87 26 9, वो वाला एरे, मतलब इसके
दैट इज डिफरेंट एरे.
सुनो मैं पूछ रहा था कि उसमें भी ये स्वैप ऑपरेशन हो रहा है, लेकिन उसमें क्या हो रहा है, उसमें पहले तो मतलब इंडेक्स 0 और इंडेक्स 1 का स्वैप हो रहा है, उसके बाद
लेट मी गो टू दैट स्लाइड. Okay, so here.
आप index 0 और index 1 का सबसे पहले swap होगा?
No, here we have to find the we have to find the index for a corresponding node where the first heapify operation will be applied. That is important. So initially unsorted array will be given. This is the unsorted array. 12, 35, 87. 26 9 28 7. Okay, so this unsorted array will be given to you. From this unsorted array you have to build up a binary tree. So here on the left hand side we first build up a binary tree. Okay, so first element is 12. 12 will be inserted as root node. Okay, then we have the element 35. So 35 will be inserted as left child, because all the insertions into the binary tree will be made from left to right. So 35 will be inserted as left child. Okay, and here 87 is the third element, and here 87 will be inserted as right child of 12. Okay, this is not the binary, this is binary tree. From the unsorted array we build up a binary tree, then we apply heapify operation, and after applying heapify operation we will have this binary heap. And in the binary heap, maximum element will be found in the at the root node position. Okay, that means in the max heap, root node will be having the maximum element.
हाँ सर, आप बोल रहा था कि जो पहले जो मतलब इंडेक्स जीरो और इंडेक्स वन,
तुम थोड़ा सा जोर जोर से बोलो, सुनाई नहीं दे रहा है तुम्हारा तुम्हारा वॉल्यूम।
तो सबसे ठीक है, तो सबसे पहले सर इंडेक्स जीरो और इंडेक्स वन का हिपीफाई ऑपरेशन होगा इसके अंदर।
ये तो इंडेक्स जीरो का क्यों होगा, आई मीन दिस इज द आई मीन ये तो तुम्हारा इंडेक्सिंग है। हम इंडेक्स जीरो कहां से किसको बोलेंगे, इंडेक्स वन किसको बोलेंगे, इंडेक्स टू किसको बोलेंगे। तो इंडेक्सिंग शुड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम रूट नोड। ओके, नाउ अप्लाई द हिपीफाई ऑपरेशन, व्हिच नोड विल बी सिलेक्टेड, दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट। व्हिच नोड विल बी सिलेक्टेड, द नोड विल बी, सो ए पर्टिकुलर नोड विल बी सिलेक्टेड वेयर वी विल सी the childrens are already hippified. okay childrens, okay. That is left child and right child, both are hippified. When the both child will be hippified, such parent node will be selected for hippify operation. Even if okay, if sir. it is not true, then we will find some I, okay, index and the corresponding node and on which the hippify operation is applied.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So up to this, everything is clear to you? Okay. Let us go to the next slide. So in this slide, we will see the Hipshot algorithm. So in the Hipshot algorithm, first step, we will build a max or min heap from the input data. So usually we build a max heap from the input data. That means the given input array. Okay. And in the second step, we will find the largest element, that is the largest item or largest element at the root. Okay. In the heap, in the binary heap. Then it is replaced with the last item of the binary heap, followed by reducing the size of heap by one. Okay, and finally we hippify the root of the tree. Okay, so first we build a maximum heap, then in the maximum heap, largest element will be found at the root node, and this largest element will be exchanged with the last element of the max heap. Okay, and then we will we will put this maximum element into the last position of the of an empty array. Okay, and we will repeat these steps while the size of the heap is greater than one. Okay. Any question from this part?
No, sir.
Any question from this part?
No, sir. No.
Okay. Now in this slide, we define the hippify operation. So for hippify operation, here we have defined hippify function, which is called hippify. Okay. And this function uses three parameters. That is, one is array, another is n. N represent the number of elements, and I represent a node where the first hippify operation will be applied. Okay. So now we define largest equal to I, and L equals to 2i plus 1. Here L represent the left child, and R equals to 2i plus 2. R represent the right child. Now if L less than n and L less than n and value at L is found to be greater than value at largest, then we assign L to largest. Okay, L to largest. Okay, if right is found to be less than n and the value at R is found to be less than value at largest, then R will be assigned to largest. Okay, and if largest is not equal to I, then we go for swapping. That is, swapping will be performed between value at I and value at largest. Okay, and again, so since if I operation is applied recursively, so we again call this ipfy function with array number of elements and the largest variable. Okay, so can you say what is the time complexity of this ipfy operation? A binary tree will be from the unsorted array. We have built a binary tree, and from this binary tree, we will have a maximum maxheap. So binary heap. Okay. So again, we build up a binary tree in which the maximum element will be found at the root node. That is called maxheap. Okay. So what will be the time complexity of this ipfy operation?
Sir, n log n.
N log n. Why n log n?
Because sir, वो मतलब जो tree बनाने में तो आपको log n times लगता है और उसको आप swap करोगे तो n times तो लग जाएगा तो उसको एक साथ कर देंगे तो n log n.
No, I am just asking for ipfy operation.
Okay.
Ipfy operation. Another operation that is build maxheap is there. That means if we run this for loop, okay. So if we run this for loop where I will start from n by 2 minus 1, okay. So until and unless we found I equals to 0, so this for loop will be run. And under this for loop, ipfy operation will work. Okay, now to build maxheap, there will be a time complexity. Okay, and for ipfy operation itself, there will be another time complexity. And when we combine both this time complexity, we will have the time complexity n log n.
Okay, sir.
That means if we run this for loop, to run this for loop to build up a maxheap, we require order of n time.
Order of n.
Okay.
Yes.
There is no doubt about order of n time complexity. Now, now to apply ipfy operation. Yes, Sarathi.
Yes, sir. Means when we are breaking the thing, means for the ipfy operation only, the time complexity would be order of n. And when we are breaking it for that sorting operation,
first and build. Okay. First, you tell me what is the time complexity to build a binary tree.
Sir, log n.
Log n. Very good. Log n. Okay. Now, now after applying ipfy operation, so what we get in the final output? Maximum maxheap.
Sorted.
So we have maxheap in the output. In the maxheap, maximum element will be found at the root node. So maxheap is nothing but a binary tree.
Yes, sir.
Binary tree. Okay. So what about the operations we apply if at the final stage if we obtain a binary tree, then for that binary tree, time complexity will be order of log n.
Order of log n. Order of log n. Operation ka
ipfy operation. Then if we combine order of log n and order of n, then
we get order of n log n
time complexity.
Yes, sir. That's what I'm telling. Means for the ipfy operation alone, it would be order of n, and create and build for that thing, it would be order of log n. So when we combine, it would be order of n log n.
Exactly. Yes.
Yes, sir.
So time complexity will be order of
n log n.
Okay. Okay, so that's all for today. And you please write down an assignment, programming assignment, last programming assignment from this part.
Okay. Okay.
Should I tell you now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The first assignment, write a program to build up a massive from a binary tree of unsorted elements Okay. The second assignment will be very simple. The second assignment is write a program to build up a binary tree from an unsorted array.
Sir, binary tree banana hai.
Now, if you include this program, if you include the second program in the first program, then there will be one large program.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay, if we include the second program. Yes, Anna.
Sir, please repeat the first question.
First question is write a program to build up a massive.
Sir, did not understand that word. Build up?
Build up a massive.
Binary massive.
From a binary tree.
Can you spell it out?
Okay. Binary we will be sending in the group.
Binary massive.
Okay.
Binary massive. Okay. Okay. Binary massive. From a binary of unsorted elements.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I am asking if you include the second program in the first program, then you can have a large program. That means in that large program, everything will be included from starting from the building up a binary tree from unsorted array. Okay. And from that binary tree, you will build up a massive. Okay. And from that massive, you will find a sorted array by removing the maximum element from the last position after exchanging with the root node. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
So today is the Thursday. You better to submit Wednesday in the next week.
Okay, sir.
Wednesday in the
okay, sir.
So this assignment will be your last assignment.
Hmm. Okay.
Sir, we will mail you or in the Google Classroom.
No. You can upload in the Google Classroom or you can mail me. So both apps.
Okay, sir. Available.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Both options will be available to you.
Okay.
Okay, so that's all for today.
Okay, thank you, sir.
And I will let you know if anything to be done from my side. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.